My name's Carmen Papalia, and today I conducted a project called the Touchy Subject. So today we're offering visitors an opportunity to go on a one-on-one tour in which an educator would guide them around and invite them to touch various aspects of the museum, closing your eyes and really focusing on tactile experience and tactile interpretation, a tour based on what could be felt.
For me, I was coming here to see the museum, and I found this opportunity and was something absolutely, absolutely amazing.
The museum is a great place for experimentation. And really, I'm just tapping into the other sensory experiences that one could have in a museum. All of these touchable aspects of the museum and touch objects really help them connect to either art objects themselves or to the place.
Everybody knows this building and everything, but when you feel it with your hands, with your eyes closed, you can feel all the ideas that the architect had when he made it, all the different shapes, the different turns.
A building that holds artwork, you walk through, look at a piece, look at a piece, look at a piece. But moving through and actually not seeing the pieces, you realize that the building itself is a piece of art in and of itself.
I had this real strong sense of the air, the movement of the air in the museum, and how that felt on my skin. I really started to feel more comfortable in the space. I was surprised how quickly that happened, just 15 minutes.
All the time receiving so much information through your eyes, that you're like letting many, many things pass on your side and you're never noticed.
He is sort of using his practice, I think, to sensitize sort of a broader public or a broader range of people about what it means to be able to enjoy and experience art through other senses. It's not necessarily, you know, sort of about blindness, but it's about what kind of tools can we use outside of sight to help people sensitize themselves to their environment or sensitize themselves to what it means to look at art.
And so it kind of was a combination of a very individualistic experience, but then also really emphasized the fact that I was part of a huge building and a big, you know, community of people.
There was this woman that I was taking around who was from Australia. She was really taking it all in, and when her hand was on the parapet, she was feeling every single groove and it getting bigger and smaller, and I just feel like she was really experiencing everything, including like the breeze, the wind.
The guests really loved that aluminum object with the enamel on it. And I brought them in front of a painting where the artist used that.
What she said was that's how he does his painting on the aluminium, with the paint and the roller. If you feel that first, perhaps before you come in with your eyes closed, and then you see his paintings, it makes a lot more sense and you get a feeling of how he's done it and what he did with it, sort of things.
She asked me to open my eyes in front of that one that we started at, and it was like I was seeing a whole new artwork, but it was almost like I already knew it in some way because we had talked about it, and she described it to me a little bit. It definitely made me think about the different experiences that people might have in a space, and that doesn't necessarily mean physical disability. You know, for me, it, you know, age, gender, political opinion, you know, background, how much art you've seen before.
I think what struck me was Amy wanted to show me a certain spot in the rotunda where sound was totally different. It was the very center. And I was expecting to actually be closer to a wall because it felt like my voice was bouncing right off of a wall. But when I opened my eyes, I was right in the center, so that was really shocking.
It felt like I could feel sunlight or see sunlight coming through. And at this point, she told me to open my eyes, and instead of a giant window, it was a wall with a painting on it.
When you see everything, all you use basically is your vision. And today, I was like listening and feeling, and I was paying attention to all my senses at the same time.
I had people who had never been here before that started having these really interesting questions about the museum experience and how much of it is communal and how much of it is social. And so it just opened up this whole conversation in a really fun, social way.
It was really like this universal design. What works for the partially sighted or for the blind worked really well for the general visitors too. And I think they really appreciated it.
The process involved me working with a group of about 30 educators from the Guggenheim.
I think that the training day was really powerful. It brought together a group of educators that don't normally work together.
It was really a communal training experience that I thought was really beneficial and really focused on experimentation. You know, we were just kind of feeling out what to do, where to bring people, how to engage them with touch and with tactile language.
A lot of the educators are just rethinking their education practice. So they were all, they all kind of had their minds opened and blown by this experience. And it wasn't just doing this, but it was how could this be integrated into what I already do.
I teach mostly in public school classrooms as part of the LTA program. But it definitely made me think a lot about how I structure a lesson. And, you know, everyone has a different learning style and just ways that my lessons could adapt. And I feel like it could totally be something that's incorporated into a tour. Just like really surprised how much can be experienced and learned through touch.
I felt like I've been to this museum 100 times. It gave me a new perspective that I'm going to use on my tours for the sighted.
I mean, visitors were asking, do you do this all the time? And the visitors were totally on board to be swept up by these educators and go have this 15-minute experience of the building with their eyes closed. To me, that's kind of what accessibility is about.
I hope that with my work to create opportunities for people to slow down and consider those bodies of knowledge that exist that they could potentially get lost in and explore and get curious by as well.